This week, Mosaic revealed three brand new products. One is an upgraded version of the Palette 2, the Palette 3 and the Palette 3 Pro, but also the Element HT and the normal Element, a 3D printer made by Mosaic, and also the Airy, a super machine, a 3D printing robot. But I also have a closer look on the FLSun Super Racer. Getting the latest news and updates right here on Sakri's 3D Prints. Hello, I'm Sakri, and this channel is about 3D printing, with tips, tricks, tutorials, how to review, news, anything 3D printing or 3D printer related you can find right here on this channel. If you're new here and not subscribed yet, please consider subscribing and hit the notification button to get the latest news and updates right in your YouTube alerts. And if you want to have an inside scoop before YouTube, check me on Twitter, Zachary_Bergen. And thanks for being here. On Tuesday, Mosaic came with three brand new products, the Palette 3 and the Palette 3 Pro, Element and the Element HT, and also the Array or Array. Before we are going to the Palette 3, let's check the bigger ones from the announcement. The Element and the Element HT are basically 3D printers that are enclosed. These two machines can print basically every kind of materials with temperatures up to 500 degrees Celsius in a heated chamber as well. You can print with these 3D printers, you can print 8 different kind of materials. With this machine, you can print high temps material with ease. The prices of these machines are between the $5,999 and $10,000. The Array is a huge 3D printer, a huge robot 3D printer. Say like the Element HT, but then bigger. You have one 3D printer on the upper left side and three on the right side of the machine. On the left side, there is a trolley where build plates are being placed when prints are ready. When a print is done, the plate is going to take out of the 3D printer by this robot and put into this trolley. Yes, correct. This machine has a robot arm or a robot hand that takes the build plate out and put it into the trolley and starts a new print. All of the four 3D printers have up to 8 different kind of materials to choose from. The Array, but also the Element, are industry focused, and therefore for the Array is no price available. You have to inquire that price. I don't put any links of those two machines in the description of this video, but if you are interested, please check the link in the description of this video. The Palette 3 and the Palette 3 Pro versions are upgraded versions from the Palette 2 and the Palette 2 Pro. This is not looking the same as the previous versions. These ones are looking different. From the outside, it's still a boxed shape, but on the inside, it looks very differently. I don't have a Mosaic palette here, but based on the pictures and the video that I saw on YouTube, they don't look the same. While the Palette 2 has 4 different kind of step motors, the Palette 3 doesn't seem to have this. This is all done by a camshaft kind of system. For the Palette 3 Pro, the Splice Core Pro is 10 times faster than the normal Splice Core. And it also looks like the cooling zone is longer than the one that they used on the Palette 2. And with cooling zone, I mean the tube where the whole filament after splicing and melting together, it's going all the way to a Bowden tube and then into your 3D printer. So that on the 3 looks way longer. The Palette 3 and the Palette 3 Pro have a LCD touchscreen and also a built-in Wi-Fi connectivity to connect your palette and your printer to your laptop or computer. The Palette 3 costs around the $499, and you can print up to 4 different kinds of materials. And you have a 1-year warranty. The Palette 3 Pro costs $699, and you can print 8 different kinds of colors, and you have 2 years of warranty. I'll put the link in the description where you can buy this one. FLSEN came with a brand new Delta 3D printer a short time ago, the FLSEN SR, or Super Razor. The Super Razor has similarities with the FLSEN QQS Pro. But what is different? To start with the lineal rails instead of the smooth rods for the Delta movements. The rods to move the printhead around are made out of carbon, and they use springs to keep those rods together. So on the printhead side, but also on the pillar side of the Delta printer. And they use a Bontech BMG clone and a Velcono hot end, not a E3D Volcano hot end. The main board is now located at the top instead of the bottom, because this Delta 3D printer has a tool draw. The main board is a 32-bit board with the TMC2208 stepper drivers. And in the animation, I see a spare driver. I'm not sure if this one can be used in a future upgrade. Further, they stated at the end of the video that this Delta 3D printer has auto leveling, but it is not really attached to the printhead. It's just the same kind of thing as the QQS Pro has. You have to attach it on the bottom of the printhead. Nice to see that the Carbo Random glass bed is removable by unscrewing 6 screws that hold 3 clamps. The Super Razor has a 3.5-inch LCD touchscreen on one of the pillars, and it looks way better. Something similar like you can see on the Ender 3 version 2. This Delta 3D printer has a printing volume of 260 mm in diameter and 330 mm in height. And the default printing speed is 150 mm per second default. The price of the Super Razor is $399, and I'll put the link in the description of this video. So to wrap up this video, we can add more colors to our prints with the brand new Mosaic Palette 3 and the Palette 3 Pro, but also printing at higher speeds with the Super Razor from FLSEN. Maybe we can combine them and high-speed color printing. Can we do this? This video is supported by these awesome Patreon supporters: Loyal Moses, Michael, and the Lightspeed. Thank you for your awesome support every single time. You can also support this channel by checking the Patreon link in the description of this video. If you're still watching this video, thank you, you are amazing. On the end card, there's some recommended videos worth watching. And while you're at there, check out the merch in the merch store to support this channel as well. Please like this video, share this video with other people and on social media. And hey, let's make some fun with 3D printing. Zachary 3D Prints. Bye-bye.